Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tennessee Titans franchise. We got a few things to go over today before we head into the final game of the season. And we will have the offseason episode. I don't know when that will be out, but that will be pretty fun. Pretty good stuff. So players ready to negotiate. I'm pretty much done with that. I don't want anyone back. Derrick Henry is going to be at the top of this list. Don't want him back. Sean Murphy Bunting was probably their worst player in all the whole secondary all year long. Nick Westbrook Akina, no interest. And same with Aaron Brewer. I don't have interest. He has interest in being here. I don't want him here. And I've offered him a couple of deals to be like a lifelong backup. Not going to happen. Autry's going to walk. He's 33 years old, not really too much there. And Ryan Tannehill, 35 years of age. I don't want Caleb Farley. Will go ahead and probably just accept his option and move along and move on with him. So I was debating letting Malik Willis play this last game and start, and to keep, you know, Will Levis, our quarterback of the future, you know, obviously hasn't really played to that caliber. And I think I will, but running back, we're gonna sit Derrick Henry. We're going to sit DeAndre Hopkins. I just don't want any major huge injuries that plays into next year, like a torn ACL or anything bizarre happening. I brought Kevin Austin up from the practice squad, and we'll be using him along with Akina, and Treylon Burks will start, and Colton Dowell, Reggie Robertson will all get their chances. Kyle Phillips, I don't know why he's not up here. Actually, now that I think about it, he'll still get some reps, I promise. And then tight end Josh Wiley's out of that fullback spot, which I've been kind of complaining about for a while. Left tackle will be Andrew Dillard, and then I think we have Jalen Duncan. Okay, I wanted to start Jalen Duncan, but he actually, I'll show you guys a cool stat that I have, but basically just wanted to let you guys know that we're sitting all of our starters, and Jeffrey Simmons, Rashad Weaver will come in and play. Harold Landry will still play like a pretty okay role, nothing like insane. So I was talking about the stats, right? So I'll go to blocking here real quick, and look at this. Downs played, you see Peter Skoronski, he's only allowed one sack, which is really good. But look at Aaron Brewer, almost played 900 snaps and second highest on the team, played in 15 games and zero sacks allowed. So that was actually kind of bizarre to me, and seeing that makes me kind of want to, you know, let him, you know, back in. But look at Jalen Duncan here. He started a lot in the beginning of the season because Nicholas Petit-Frere was indeed suspended, and he let five sacks up. Petit-Frere, since he's come back, he's only let up four. Let's go with 1-2 for Andre Dillard. So we just don't seem to get sacked from the interior, and when we do, it's not when Aaron Brewer's present, as he's done a really good job this season of really protecting his quarterback, but hasn't been the extreme, you know, tackler or movement guy or anything insane for the run game. Enough with that. I'll show you guys our players that we have up here on the board. So I've gone through and I've actually sorted through. So we'll see from top five all the way down to the UDFAs that I have. We have how many people in here? 63 players favorited. I don't know if we'll be able to get through all of them, but I'll show you guys kind of my favorites. My favorites of, you know, these round one guys is probably Montag. And then we can go down quite a bit here. And Grant Ellington's probably my favorite of these round one to twos. Clyde Claxton's pretty close to my favorite out of those ones. And then Deon Parnell's one to highlight. Jalen Reynolds probably not gonna draft. Nelson McLeod isn't horrible or doesn't look bad. And then Jalen Peel actually was one of my favorite players here. I think he's a pretty good athlete as well, if I remember correctly. Otis Nash has an elusive back, but I don't know if we'll end up drafting him. Bob Rushing in the 3-4 looks a great value from what I can see. Same with Robinson, and got a lot of linebackers in here as well, which is rough, as we also have a big divot in linebacker. But there's just such a variety in this class that we should be able to fill that pretty easily down the board. Emmanuel Judge, though, is another receiver I'm looking at. He's not really amazing by any means, but Carlos Diaz in the day three looks really good. And Boise State, 6'6", 273 possession tight end. Not the best athlete, but could come in and play as our tight end two or even one if he were to be like a 71 overall and we wanted to change things up from Chigakonkwo, who's not your traditional tight end. Cam Gordon, Aaron Bates, Demetrius Darby. Like, we have players, right? And they all look so good down the board, but one that is my absolute favorite is the elusive back out of Maine. A ball carry vision, C break tackles, B carrying, and he's got good to great speed, great to elite jumping. The acceleration and agility is not the best at all, but just look at the player. He doesn't look bad at all, and hopefully he could you know, come in and be okay. Like, I'm talking like 66 overall plus, and we definitely try to work him in. And we have Addison Reed, Mitchell Huff down the board as our kind of punter kicker. Weekly strategy, I want to just do the medium pass. I want to focus on that, and then we'll move to offensive game plan, where I just want to stop the blitz from coming in so hot, and we'll do the traditional, if you guys have ever seen this before, one interception, 24 points or less, 300 yards, and no sacks allowed. Those are my favorite, and I'm not going to do any drills or anything, just excited to get into the last game of the season. Upgrade to our special teamers, Caleb Shudak and Stonehouse. I want power to go out for Caleb Shudak. Actually been a pretty good kicker for us in year one, so I don't really want to see him kind of just, you know, fade. I'd like to see him develop here as our kicker, but you know, if we can improve at the position, I'm not going to hesitate. Trevor Lawrence on the season has had a pretty good one. 24 touchdowns, only 9 interceptions, doing his job well. We have the older stuff on, and you saw the Jags in the same thing. 2015 throwbacks, as they all have their 2015 stuff on, and we'll have ours. Cook to kick this one off to Reggie Robertson. Of course, he'll be our returner. He's been really good all season long, and almost, you know, probably could have returned that one if we chose the right spot. Malik Willis doesn't really have numbers on the season, but when he plays, he hasn't been horrible, and I like his athletic ability. Out of all of the quarterbacks, he's probably my favorite to user. 25 of 66, 315, a touchdown, but those 4 interceptions always hurt to see when a quarterback has more interceptions than touchdowns, but smaller sample size, and we'll look to get our starting running back going. Tyjae Spears back here, and I'm going to have to make I think I already had this switch, but I'm going to make sure. Yeah, third down back is Julius Chestnut, who I was going to try to get involved in today's game. We'll see what Tyjae Spears can do as Aaron Brewer. Kind of just weird movement from him, and I couldn't really work off of what he was doing, so that's unfortunate. The first run out was not what we were expecting, but I already want to switch it up. Let's go with some play action. Let's get Malik Willis in a little bit of a bootleg situation. Give him a chance in this one. Trevon Walker's using his spidey senses to turn around and get that one. I like the matte black on those helmets there. Don't look bad at all. Julius Chestnut into the game now. We'll see if we can get him on a nice route and see if he can create any separation or do anything, as we're going to go for our leading receiver right now. Our wide receiver one in the game would be Treylon Burks, but three and out. Fourth down, wound up punting this one away. And then obviously not the elephant in the room. I think that we still have a very good player in Alibi in the middle of the field, or at least a great athlete, but he might end up, you know, we might draft someone else, because Alibi, who's been a great hero, he's a practice squad 61 overall with like 90 plus speed, and that was kind of what we were looking for at the position, as well, he just kind of got bitched as Etienne moves up the field. And Tier Tart gets injured, one of our starting defensive tackles. He's playing that defensive tackle one today because Simmons is actually out, as I have made sure he's not going to get injured today. And this one out in the flat, Christian Kirk steps up the field after breaking a tackle. Broken ribs for Tier Tart. Perrion Winfrey is going to have to come in and be our defensive tackle one today, and maybe that subs in Simmons. It won't, so that's good. So I'm going to use Alibi on the other side here just to make sure that nothing bizarre happens. We'll use Alibi lead with our shoulder, and weird animations going on. First and goal on the one, and they'll try to bring it in as Alibi lays him out, but just before it's too late. McManus's kick is up and good. 7-0. Their momentum meter is slowly moving up, and that's not good. Let's see what we can get going here early in the pass game. Kyle Phillips into the game. He's our slot receiver. We'll try to roll out. Can we get anything happening here? Nope. Just lobbed it up to what was supposed to be Tyjae Spears. It didn't end up materializing like that, I'll tell you that. It's fucking annoying. Anyways, yeah, what a start. First and goal now, as I mean, thought I was in a good position there, but apparently Evan Ingram's just better. Etienne gets the touchdown. I know it's Etienne, but it's just funny to say Etienne and Mock MMG. Papa Meeks, if you guys know him, I'm sure you guys do. McManus's kick is up, and of course, good. 14-0. Full momentum in Jags favor. Oh man, I can't make any dumb decisions like that again with Malik Willis, and we'll come out and try to be better. Let's go Wiley underneath, catch that one in traffic. You're not that bad, I tell you that. If you're making the NFL roster, if you're making a roster in the NFL, you're gonna make that catch, and that's just gonna happen. Julius Chestnut on his first rush of the year goes for 4 yards, and now we have ourselves a very tough situation, and we'll try to do slot choice spot. I don't want to do a QB draw because they have a pretty loaded box, and that can really play against us at this point in time. Let's go Treylon Burks, trying to break a tackle, move up the field. They're going to credit us with the first before they can overrule or anything. This is where we will run QB draw. We'll let them kind of go back, and blocking was not in our favor there. Holy shit, we suck. I've been waiting to see Tyjae Spears in this starting back running back role all year long, and so far has not materialized into anything but 3rd and 10. And rolling out now, can we make that throw in rhythm? Malik Willis down the field to our wide receiver one, Treylon Burks. Great job from him getting down the field, deeper crossing route, and just makes a good play on that one. And Malik Willis with one hell of a throw. We haven't seen anything like that, and that's a huge spark to our fire here. That is called our offense. And on this one, just looking for something again. And Malik Willis does get up a few, maybe. Was that a loss? I thought it was going to be 3rd and 10. I guess not. Julius Chestnut will bring in here. I'm not going for points. I'm going for the, or I'm not going for the 3 points. I want the touchdown. So give me an opportunity here. We'll go for Traylon Burks and, hey, pass interference, anyone? No, this one's literally just airmail. No chance of catching it at all. We'll go with the field goal with Caleb Shudak. And this one should be pretty automatic. He hasn't missed a kick, I think, all year long, if I'm not mistaken. He's gotten close. But 3-14, they are not in full momentum. We'll just try to get after Trevor Lawrence. 1st and 10 now for Taylor Swift and the rest of this Jags team as we'll try to get Zay Jones down. And Sean Murphy Bunting can never wrap up. And this one just going to thread a needle here. And Christian Kirk's going to do a good job breaking another tackle. We need to turn our tackle slider up. What's going on here? And another open guy up the seam. It's Zay Jones, who's just going to continue to accumulate yards at this point. Trevor Lawrence is just firing on all cylinders right now. And right as that ball is snapped, the ball is out of his hands. And he looks absolutely phenomenal right now. Or absolutely just insanely good. In this one, separation at the top of the route. Alibi cannot be in man coverage. He sucks other than when I'm usering him, and he's still not that great then, but just an athlete. But I don't know. 21-3, what do we have to hold on to at this point? We are getting crushed. Like I said, I want to see what Malik Willis has, so I don't care how many mistakes we make with him. I'm going to continue to just throw with him here. Get him in rhythm. Nope, I didn't even mean to scramble out. That would have been a Kevin Austin reception. Tyjae Spears, that's a yard. Been really held to the minimum here today. And give me Traylon Burks underneath. Make a play. He won't be able to. And Nick Westbrook-Ikhina goes down. Oh, man. And it's not like really... Oh, that's so bad to see. Like, I don't care. 1st and 10, we're seeing a Trevor Lawrence audible real quick, and they will be up and running now as Calvin Ridley now gets the quickest pass of all time. I'm gonna go over to these wideouts here. It doesn't matter, dude. The ball is snapped. Trevor Lawrence has that ball out of his hand. By the time that the center can actually get it to his hands, I think the ball's already gone. Listen to me. Trevor Lawrence is not this good. It's just not. No. 2nd and inches. We'll look to keep ourselves in this one. And that is what I'm talking about. What the fuck? I want to die. 1st and 10. ETN on a little dump down. Only good for a yard. That's the longest Trevor Lawrence held onto a ball for a whole 2 seconds, possibly. Could have even been faster than that. But so far, we have just failed to come out and impress with any backups. I was hoping that at this point, we'd see some impact player that we weren't expecting to have an impact today. But nope. 15-15, 174 yards and a touchdown. It's official. Trevor Lawrence is your MVP. Like, what the hell? Why? What did we do? What did we do to deserve such things? As we will stay underneath. Azeez Al-Shaair, dumbass. You better, like, I don't know. Just do better. 1st and 10. Evan Engram gets tackled for a loss after just a 1 yard loss. This team, I'm sure, will convert and get a first down. It's just the way that this team seems to operate. As Elijah Molden and I, they're spreading out pretty wide here. I want to make sure that we get Alibi somewhat in the remote area as Elijah Molden comes in and does such a good job. I like Elijah Molden. He played a really good game in week 1 in real life. And I wouldn't be opposed to him having a role next year as well, because he doesn't look bad when he plays, and he's a pretty for-sure tackler, which is something I also noticed, as this one moves up the seam, and I think that was Elijah Molden. If not, it was mine, but I wasn't going to leave Evan Engram wide open in first down territory. I was going to make Trevor Lawrence work for it, and maybe pressure gets to him before then, but I don't know what I'm thinking that we get pressure at all, because obviously that's just not a thing. I'd watch a run right here. This seems to be a pretty run spot, and Azeez Al-Shaair does a good job. 2nd and goal, we're gonna see some sort of trickery. Alibi's not having it. He's in the backfield. TFL for what's his name, Segun Alibi. And this one underneath, touchdown. We were never gonna stop it. It's just the CPU playing with our emotions. Reggie Robertson headed to the locker room, so that's kind of a bummer, but we'll try with Tyjae Spears again from the backfield. Aaron Brewer's gonna have to do a better job, man. Get up, do your job. Maybe I'll actually consider running behind you. They are just stacking the box every play. They know our weakness, and that's throwing the ball. And Devin Lloyd, I thought, would easily have a sack right here, but nope. Instead, it's a good play. Traylon Burks will get out of bounds. That's late contact for fucking sure. We'll run the ball now. Tyjae Spears trying to work up the field. Only 2 yards. We'll go hurry up. 6 rushes for 9 yards. That's very nice, but love to keep that stat line. Except Trayvon Walker is going to try to prevent that sidearm from Malik Willis. And Chigakonkwo breaks 2 tackles, works up the field on Foye Oluokun. That's really, really cool. We're going to try Bingo Cross. No, we're not. We're going to go straight back to the run game. I want to break off like a pretty big run or like a decent one as Tajay Spears working outside does a good job getting a gain of 5. And this one snapped. Can we get that one too? Traylon Burks, we can. But they will suck us into an animation where there is nothing we can do about it. As we'll go back to the run game, we've just been in hurry up. I'm just trying to make a good play as that's exactly what that guy just did. I don't even know who the hell that is. Dogby. And we'll stay somewhat central. We'll try to move out of the pocket with Malik Willis. And we'll just throw this one away. Late contact, rough the passer, all the above. I wouldn't be opposed to throwing this one up either to Calvin Austin or Traylon Burks. I'm opposed to doing that now. This one's picked off again. This one was for Josh Wiley crossing the middle of the field. Instead, it's airmailed to a sideline, not even 20 yards in a zone of where Josh Wiley could have caught it. Sorry, he's 6'4 or whatever. He's not getting that. And Sean Murphy bunting lets up a huge gain and just... Christian Kirk creates separation on the top of the route. That's how you know your ass is if Christian Kirk can separate from you like that easily on one little, I don't even know. That wasn't even a post. As Rashad Weaver out in coverage on Christian Kirk. Give me a fucking break. Trevor Lawrence has started 21 of 21. 22 of 22. 23 of 23. Evan Engram moves up the field. 271 yards and 2 touchdowns. Oh, you've got to be absolutely kidding me. That was going to be a TFL, but Madden said, fuck you, idiot. You're not doing shit, dumbass. And just put me in the dust. 25 of 25. 292, 2 touchdowns. Come and get the Hall of Fame game. Where it seems like our players should be playing. All these guys are on a preseason roster right now. This is fucking ridiculous. We can't generate a single stop or anything. Is this one Alibi? Insane athlete. That's the only way he's useful. I'm going to call a timeout here. Touchdown, Etienne. Woohoo! Go Jags, baby. Woohoo! This one's up and good. I'm going to sue Madden and EA for mental reasons. This is getting fucked. Malik Willis coming out like he didn't just throw the biggest duck of all time. And well, I like the confidence, but I don't like the way you play the game of football, buddy. So give him another chance. This one underneath picked off. Nope. Surprising. We'll cut our losses, call a draw, and hope Julius Chestnut can work up the field. Doesn't really seem to be working out for him in the long run of things here, but we got him thinking that we're going to run the football. So maybe play action's a little bit better here. So we'll try that. And Chigakonkwo, Wiley, all of them. Gonna try to work. No one's even close to fooled as Wiley's gonna try to work up the field. Can't. Timeout, and we'll punt this one. And they call timeouts just to kneel. You've got to be kidding me. 35-3. This is a close one. You might want to stay tuned. Too pissed to do halftime report. We'll just flip our focus onto to the run. I can't bear to throw the football anymore. Can we turn this second half around? Let me know down in the comments. See if we can score. Let me know if we score more than 14 points, because in my opinion, we just don't, as Kevin Byard just straight up gets beat. Is Evan Engram prime Travis Kelce right now? What the hell? 28-28, 338, 2 touchdowns. Trevor Lawrence is playing out of his mind right now, as the CPU literally came in, chose violence, and chose to make me want to do unspeakable things to myself as Christian Kirk. Just find your way open on the seam every play, would you? We're going full seam protection, as you can tell. We're going to leave the middle of the field wide open. And Rashad Weaver, can you do something like valuable? 12 receptions, 173 yards for Christian Kirk. 8 receptions for 93 yards from Evan Engram. Holy bejesus, we suck. That's we suck. And wide open in the end zone, Calvin Ridley beats Sean Murphy bunting. And Sean Murphy bunting, I kid you not, was not even 7 yards in the vicinity of Calvin Ridley. He got fucked that bad. He got bent over and literally just... We'll try read option here. As like I said, we just need to stick to this run game. And we will give it to Julius Chestnut, who... Actually, he feels really good. Like, okay, wait. It's fast. He feels like a faster running back than we've had in the past. As we will work with Julius Chestnut again. Working up the middle of the field. 4 rushes, 38 yards. He seems to be the only person working right now. As Chestnut is doing a great job in his new role. And it's just for this game. He's fighting for a roster spot pretty much. I don't even know if he'll be on the team next year. As is that Skoronski? No, it's Brunskill. That explains everything. And Chestnut underneath catches. Can he make someone miss? He got close to making someone miss, which is good. I like to see a better try though. But let's try to flip the play here, go Chestnut towards a weaker side. Trevon Walker isn't that great of a run defender, but we'll see what he can do, as he can do nothing as Chestnut working up the field once again, and Aaron Brewer goes down. It doesn't look good. Tyjae Spears today, 10 rushes, 17 yards. I'm considering pulling the plug on him playing for the rest of the day, just because we know he hasn't worked out and probably won't by the end of this one. He might, you know, 50 yards is 50 yards, but we'll work up the middle of the field, try to switch and change direction, weave up the field as we do a good job on that play. See, this feels like a horrible time for a run. We only have one running back in the backfield, and they are just going to be pulling people, as this is going to be most likely a hold. Holding on Josh Wiley, and this one will be first and 20. So not forced to pass by any means, but I'm going to, as Treylon Burks has had a pretty good track record today on PA crossers. So we're going to try to work outside. Can we get that? Get that! Get it! Don't just... I can make that throw! Third and 16, the only thing we have left here, as we're just gonna do it. No way. You gotta be joking me. It's Kyle Phillips. Why is he the GOAT, and why does that work? Out of all things, that works. That's what I'm most pissed about. I'm happy we got a touchdown, cool, but that works? You're joking. Shudak's kick is up and good. It'll be 10-42, and this one will start off nice. Rashad Weaver can't tackle for shit and can't play football for shit either. Trevor Lawrence might have the record for the most consecutive passes completed, 32 of 32 to open this one. Not a good look for him, if I'm being honest, as we just don't have anything press coverage related and somehow run right past Christian Kirk. First and 10, and as we know, Trevor Lawrence has been automatic all day long today, so if we can finally stop that, which we do, 33-34. This is like winning a football game. Trevor Lawrence throws an incompletion. That feels so good to get. And look at the absolute linebacker blitz. And we got there so quick, as this is the Trevor Lawrence downfall. Third and 16. They will convert here, by the way, in case you guys were curious. And maybe not. They run the ball. Not the smartest of options, but that one is stopped, and Elijah Molden does a good job stepping up and making that play. Good awareness by him. I like Elijah. Julius Chestnut today, 5 rushes, 51 yards. He's been the player to stand out. I didn't realize it until last drive around, but Julius Chestnut has been the player to highlight. But we're going to give it to Tyjae Spears now, as he'll be into the game. And I mean, can we do anything with Tyjae? And we'll look for Chigakonkwo, who's going to get up the field. Did a good job separating at the top of his route. Malik Willis, 10 of 20 for 150 plus yards. Really good numbers from him. I'm going to look for Treylon Burks maybe early here on this one, if we can get him. And nice window, but it's a breakup, of course. Butterfingers. Same thing again. Let's go Treylon Burks. This time does bring it in. Automatic on that slant route, as we're gonna. Yep, that's a word. Let's see what we can do here. Nope. Okay. Why are you stepping back? He gets the ball thrown towards him and he goes, halt, halt. We're coming out and going for it here on fourth and two, and Julius Chestnut has been automatic today. We're going to bring it, as Radons does a good job blocking, and we had to be patient and wait for it, but we got it. And that's the big, important, grand scheme of things. Hassan Haskins into the game now. Bad person, but could be a good player. We'll see. As didn't follow his ball. I didn't follow anybody. Let's see what we can get going here in the passing offense that we have here. It's been pretty existent. I'm not going to say non-existent, but it's just been a little shaky at best. Third and seven now. They have only two takeaways today, as they've been pretty good all year on that. So we'll see. Chigakonkwo, wow, they did a really good job covering like everything. As this one will be airmail, and we did a good job to get up and get that one out. But this one, we are down a lot, and we're going to have to go for this for sure. We'll try cross. It's worked in the past. Westbrook Akina. I'm going to have Chigakonkwo stop at the top of his route, and we'll go for Akina quick, and nope, of course not. They just know. They know. They just do. They bring that safety up last second. It looked good. So it started to drop back, and he's like, wait a minute. He pressed X. Quarterback hasn't even thrown the motion in the game yet. And Christian Kirk out here, Julio Jones looking numbers. First and 10, Alibi in the backfield for his second TFL today. Etienne has 3 touchdowns on the ground despite only having 10 rushes and 23 yards. Second and 13, as they will have our safety turned around and just finds himself incomplete on that play. Third and 13 now. We'll look to make a good stop, as I don't think that will happen. This one thrown out and away. So we found something that works, and Trevor Lawrence has struggled to move the ball here in the second Not specifically in the second half, but these last two drives are three. And we'll try to get like a quick pass thing going out as Chigakonkwo will turn up the field, try to get some sort of yardage here. Let's go full speed ahead. Let's try the same play again, see if they adjust and play it a little differently. They don't, as we'll still try to get Chigakonkwo underneath. Instead, it's a thrown ball that looks like a toddler did their best Malik Willis impression, and they did a pretty damn good job. Julius Chestnut, I trust here on third and three, so we'll try to get him going as Roy Robertson Harris tries to do that. Is this face mask? Face mask on the defense here on Foye Aluakon, so we'll let that one slide as we will, I don't know. We'll try to just work the underneath parts of part of this one, as we have a wide open Tajay Spears. I don't want to miss that one, as Tajay does a good job in the receiving game and has all season long. After he gets the ball, he's been okay and decently effective. But now we will run the ball, as Tajay Spears, probably the only daylight he's seen all day, and struggles to find that hole. Julius Chestnut, who has been our secret weapon today, just gets absolutely shut down thanks to no other than Aaron Brewer. You worst piece of shit on the offensive line. You get shed like no other, idiot. Get screwed. I'm gonna try to put Traylon Burks on a go route, see if that safety drops, or they will respect him. But Chigakonkwo's route literally just got ran for him, so nothing I can do. Gonna keep Okonkwo into pass block for us instead of complicate things here on the field, as we will scramble out. Can we get that to Kyle Phillips, who I was gonna say, if he can carve up and get a second touchdown, this will be a Kyle Phillips breakout game, and that'd be quite fun. But didn't happen, as we go Tajay Spears. See how they were like in, like they were looking to stop the pass, and then once I audible to a run, they stopped and still kept that box stacked, or whatever you want to say. And they'll be in the backfield immediately. Is that Caleb on Chase on? That looks like, I don't even know, someone blaring off the edge to piss me off. And I'm gonna look for Traylon Burks here. Can't, but we do have good speed with our quarterback. Never mind, number 56 is out of his mind. You're not faster. Okay, your Sir Abdullah is really fast, but dude, are you joking me right now? How much? Okay, I want to see the speed of Malik Willis here. 90 speed, 93 Excel Jags, and let's go find outside linebacker. I believe it would be outside linebacker Yasir Abdullah. Where is Mr. Yasir? 90 speed. You're not faster than me. Horrible time for the backups to be in now, as they'll try to cap this drive off, as Colton Dowell does a good job. Nope, forgot. Once you have separation, the DB can cover every aspect of every play, of every route, of every single passing combination, and like, what is it called? There's like a lane, passing lane, every single passing lane possible. First and 10, that's Harold Landry finally showing some sort of impact today. A good starter for us, and I mean, hasn't been everything we've hoped for today, so unfortunate for sure. Second and 12, though, as they will look to run this football. Alibi to the outside, dives. Third and 5 now. I'm just going to spare timeouts. I'm not going to really try anymore. Just kind of blitz the quarterback, play press coverage, and see what can happen, if anything. And I'll try to stay leveraged here on Evan Engram. And this one, very good by Caleb Farley, using his length and size to stop that one. Trevor Lawrence hasn't completed a pass since his 33rd reception, or 33rd completion. And Julius Chestnut into the backfield. You know what I'm going to want to do? I'm going to want to run it. And they're going to probably sense that out. And this one, do Chestnut, as we will, wow. Okay, we won't do anything. He will get flipped onto his ass. Unfortunate for Mr. Chestnut, but this would be a good time to take a shot, as we don't. We're actually going to just try to run with Julius Chestnut. Wow, he looks so freaking good. What is going on? Oh, never mind. Spoke a little too early. Hitting the locker rooms. Second and one after a good completion to Nick Westbrook-Ikhina for a few yards. As we'll try to go play action and look for someone down the field. Can't. I saw, is that Kevin Austin? Was open, but I know that probably would have been a pick somehow. Chestnut rushes out of the locker room to come be with the rest of his team, as he will get upfield and get that first down on the third down. Does a really good job coming back in, get his toughness up, and do what he needs to. As we'll go underneath this one, barely caught. This one was going to get sniffed out by Andrew Sisco. Andre. Is it Andre or Andre? Andre? That's definitely Andre. What am I talking about? Been looking for Traylon Burks on this route combo all game long. This one's picked off. Yep, this one's not even in the vicinity of Mr. frickin' Westbrook and Keenum. And what is Kevin Austin doing clapping? He's like, yeah, get fucked. My quarterback threw it right to you, bozo. Cam Dantzler is someone to be reckoned with, apparently. The last two times we've gone against, I didn't press circle. I'm done with this game right now. I won't make you guys suffer and watch through the rest of this one. Trevor Lawrence with all day and will fire and get Christian Kirk, who get laid the hell out. At 420 yards, 3 touchdowns, and only 4 incompletions on the day, it's been quite good. When they entered the red zone, they've gotten 6 touchdowns today. This is what hell looks like, apparently. So we'll let the DBs play pretty far off of their assignments. This is Aziz Alshaier and Harold Landry in the backfield immediately. This one will finish up here. Victory formation. They just kneel it for the last time. This one's going to be 42-10 as our final score, as it relevantly pulls up my play menu for the last play of the game with 1 second left. So, fair play to the Jags and the CPU, who bent us over today. No other way to put it, as they have absolutely made they've stamped a huge gap. All right, the skill gap between them and us right now is huge, and they've made sure to make that very clear to us. And overall, it wasn't a horrible game from Malik Willis. I just wish that accuracy was a little bit better. I think a lot of it has to do with Madden and the way it all works, but solid game from Malik Willis compared to what we've seen from Will Levis in the past. And I don't know who we'll have moving forward play for us, but I wouldn't be opposed to Malik Willis coming in and taking a few snaps here and there if Will Levis gets injured, or we might do a little cover-up. We might have a preseason battle once again. But Julius Chestnut was really good and played really well in the role he played, averaging obviously 7.7 per carry. Christian Kirk, like I mentioned, was really good. But Treylon Burks, underrated day for him. Chigakonko had a few targets. Kyle Phillips had that big catch for the touchdown. And other than that, actually had another big play too. So really good numbers for us all the way around. A few spots to look at and know that we're doing okay. And obviously, Tyjae Spears really didn't take that step forward that I wanted him to in that RB1 spot. So unfortunate. So next episode you guys will see will be the off-season episode, as Malik Willis will get a little bit of an upgrade here. And I'd like him to be a lot better at throwing the football. He's already a phenomenal scrambler, but you see his accuracies aren't even that bad. 77 deep, 73 mid or medium, if you will, and then 78 short. Throw on the run and play action are pretty good, but under pressure needs to be a lot better. And throw on the run at 82 is actually pretty good. We have some stuff to work with Malik Willis, and I don't know if I see that same potential in Will Levis. So quarterback one is still up in the air. I'm not gonna lie, we've seen a lot of both players, and in my opinion the more fun one is definitely Malik Willis, obviously, and I've seen a little bit more out of him, and his ceiling's probably a little bit higher. What do we want here? I want Chigakonko to be like that vertical threat tight end, so we'll keep him going with that upgrade and see what that kind of courses him to. But yeah, other than that, that'll be it for me. Thank you guys for watching. If you guys enjoyed, consider leaving a like, go down and subscribe, and go watch any of my past contents, and Ian guarantee that you will go ahead and enjoy those videos. And see you guys next time. Adieuses.